Welsh mythology consists of both folk traditions developed in Wales, and traditions developed by Britons elsewhere before the end of the first millennium. Like most predominantly oral societies found in pre-Roman Great Britain, Welsh mythology and history was recorded orally by Druids. This oral record has been lost or altered as a result of outside contact and invasion over the years. Much of this altered mythology and history are preserved in medieval Welsh manuscripts, which include the Red Book of Hergest, the White Book of Rhydderch, the Book of Aneurin, and the Book of Taliesin. Other works connected to Welsh mythology include the 9th-century Latin historical compilation Historia Britannum and Geoffrey of Monmouth's 12th-century Latin chronicle Historia Regum Britanniae, as well as later folklore, such as the Welsh Fairy Book by W. Jenkin Thomas, 1908. Legends. 4 branches of the Mabinogi. Most mythological stories contained in the Mabinogian collection are collectively titled the 4 branches of the Mabinogi, which concentrate largely on the exploits of various British deities who have been Christianized into kings and heroes. The only character to appear in every branch is Pryderi fab Pwyll, the king of Dyfed, who is born in the first branch, is killed in the fourth, and is probably a reflex of the Celtic god Meponus. The only other recurring characters are Pryderi's mother Rhiannon, associated with the peaceful British prince Manawydan, who later becomes her second husband, Manawr Yadan, and his siblings Bendigeid Fran, Branwen and Efnisien are the key players of the second branch, while the fourth branch concerns itself with the exploits of the family of Don, which includes the wizard Gwydion, his nephew Llu and his sister Arianrod. Pwyll, Prince of Dyfed. The first branch tells of how Pwyll, the Prince of Dyfed, exchanges places for a year with Aron, the ruler of Annwn, defeats Aron's enemy Hafgan, and on his return encounters Rhiannon, a beautiful maiden whose horse cannot be caught up with. Rhiannon is accused of killing him and forced to carry guests on her back as punishment. The child has been taken by a monster, and is rescued by Tenon and his wife, who bring him up as their own, calling him Gwri of the Golden Hair, until his resemblance to Pwyll becomes apparent. They return him to his real parents. Rhiannon is released from her punishment, and the boy is renamed Pryderi. Branwen Ferch Llyr in the second branch. Branwen, sister of Bendigeid Fran, King of Britain, is given in marriage to Matholch, King of Ireland. Branwen's half-brother Efnisien insults Matholch by mutilating his horses, but Bendigeid Fran gives him new horses and treasure, including a magical cauldron which can restore the dead to life. In compensation, Matholch and Branwen have a son, Gwen, but Matholch proceeds to mistreat Branwen, beating her and making her a drudge. Branwen trains a starling to take a message to Bendigeid Fran, who goes to war against Matholch. His army crosses the Irish Sea in ships, but Bendigeid Fran is so huge he wades across. The Irish offer to make peace, and build a house big enough to entertain Bendigeid Fran, but inside they hang 100 bags, telling Efnisien they contain flour, when in fact they conceal armed warriors. Efnisien kills the warriors by squeezing the bags. Later, at the feast, Efnisien throws Gwen on the fire and fighting breaks out. Seeing that the Irish are using the cauldron to revive their dead, Efnisien hides among the corpses and destroys the cauldron, although the effort costs him his life. Only 7 men, all Britons, survive the battle, including Pryderi, Manawydan and Bendigeid Fran, who is mortally wounded by a poisoned spear. Bendigeid Fran asks his companions to cut off his head and take it back to Britain. Branwen dies of grief on returning home. 5 pregnant women survive to repopulate Ireland. Manawydan fab Llyr Pryderi and Manawydan return to Dyfed, where Pryderi marries Sigfur and Manawydan marries Rhiannon. However, a mist descends on the land, leaving it empty and desolate. The 4 support themselves by hunting at first, then move to England where they make a living making saddles. shields and shoes of such quality that the local craftsman cannot compete, and drive them from town to town. Eventually they return to Duvid and become hunters again. While hunting, a white boar leads them to a mysterious castle. Predary, against Manawydan's advice, goes inside, but does not return. Rhiannon goes to investigate and finds him clinging to a bowl, unable to speak. The same fate befalls her, and the castle disappears. Manawydan and Sigfa return to England as shoemakers, but once again the locals drive them out and they return to Duvid. They sow 3 fields of wheat, but the first field is destroyed before it can be harvested. The next night the second field is destroyed. Manawydan keeps watch over the third field, and when he sees it destroyed by mice he catches their leader and decides to hang it. A scholar, a priest and a bishop in turn offer him gifts if he will spare the mouse, but he refuses. When asked what he wants in return for the mouse's life, he demands the release of Predary and Rhiannon and the lifting of the enchantment over Duvid. The bishop agrees, because the mouse is in fact his wife. He has been waging magical war against Duvid because he is a friend of Gwawl, whom Pwyll, Predary's father, humiliated. Math Fabmathonwy. While Predary rules Duvid in South Wales, Gwynedd in North Wales is ruled by Math, son of Mathonwy. His feet must be held by a virgin, except while he is at war. Math's nephew Gilfaethli is in love with Goewin, his current footholder, and Gilfaethli's brother Gwydion tricks Math into going to war against Predary so Gilfaethli can have access to her. Gwydion kills Predary in single combat, and Gilfaethli rapes Goewin. Math marries Goewin to save her from disgrace, and banishes Gwydion and Gilfaethli, transforming them into a breeding pair of deer, then pigs, then wolves. After 3 years they are restored to human form in return. Math needs a new footholder, and Gwydion suggests his sister, Arianne Rot, but when Math magically tests her virginity, she gives birth to 2 sons. One, Dylan, immediately takes to the sea. The other child is raised by Gwydion, but Arianne Rod tells him he will never have a name or arms unless she gives them to him, and refuses to do so. But Gwydion tricks her into naming him Lleulaw Jiffus, and giving him arms. She then tells him he will never have a wife of any race living on earth, so Gwydion and Math make him a wife from flowers, called Blodywed. But Blodywed falls in love with a hunter called Gron Pebr, and they plot to kill Lleu. Blodywed tricks Lleu into revealing the means by which he can be killed, but when Gron attempts to do the deed, Lleu escapes, transformed into an eagle. Gwydion finds Lleu and transforms him back into human form, and turns Blodywed into an owl, renaming her Blodywed and cursing her as well in the process. Gron offers to compensate Lleu, but Lleu denies and insists on returning the blow that was struck against him. Gron pleads to hide behind a rock when he attempts to kill him. Lleu agrees. He kills Gron with his spear, which is thrown so hard it pierces him through the stone he is hiding behind. Cadgodr. A large tradition seems to have once surrounded the Battle of the Trees, a mythological conflict fought between the Sons of Don and the forces of Annwn, the Welsh Otherworld, and seemingly connected to the fourth branch of the Mabinogi. Amithon, one of the Sons of Don, steals a white roebuck and a whelp from Aron, king of the Otherworld, leading to a great battle. The Uwalder leads the attack, while the Aspen falls in battle, and heaven and earth tremble before the Oak, a valiant doorkeeper against the enemy. The bluebells combine in cause of consternation, but the hero is the holly, tinted with green. A warrior fighting alongside our own cannot be vanquished unless his enemies can guess his name. Gwydion guesses the warrior's name, identifying him from the sprigs of alder on his shield, and sings two in glints. Sure-hoofed is my steed, impelled by the spur, the high sprigs of alder are on thy shield. Native Tales. The Dream of Maxon. Wledig. This account is so different from Geoffrey of Monmouth's account of Maximian in Historia Regum Britanniae that scholars agree the dream cannot be based purely on Jeffrey's version. The dream's account also seems to accord better with details in the triads, so it perhaps reflects an earlier tradition. Maxon Wledig, the Emperor of Rome, dreams one night of a lovely maiden in a wonderful, far-off land. Awakening, he sends his men all over the earth in search of her. With much difficulty they find her in a rich castle in Britain, daughter of a chieftain based at Saguntum, and lead the emperor to her. Everything he finds is exactly as in his dream. The maiden, whose name is Helen or Elin, accepts and loves him. Because Elin is found a virgin, Maxon gives her father sovereignty over the island of Britain and orders three castles built for his bride. In Maxon's absence, a new emperor seizes power and warns him not to return. With the help of men from Britain led by Elin's brother Conanus, Maxon marches across Gaul and Italy and recaptures Rome. In gratitude to his British allies, Maxon rewards them with a portion of Gaul that becomes known as Brittany. Ludden Lefelys, another mythological story included in the Mabinogion collection, is the tale of Ludden Lefelys. Lud is king of Britain, and his brother, Lefelys, is king of France. Lud's kingdom is beset by three menaces. The Coronii Aed, a demonic people who can hear everything, a terrible scream that is heard every May Eve that terrifies the people, and the continual disappearance of the provisions of the king's court. Lud asks Lefelys for help, speaking to him through a brass tube so the Coronii can't hear. Lefelys creates a potion of crushed insects in water which destroys the Coronii when sprinkled on them. The scream, he discovers, comes from two dragons fighting. He gets the dragons drunk on mead and buries them in Dinas Emrys in what is now North Wales. He then overcomes the wizard who is stealing all of Lud's provisions and makes him serve Lud. Haynes Taliesin Guest included Haynes Taliesin in her translation of the Mabinogion. Despite the absence of this tale from the White Book of Rutherk and the Red Book of Hergest, subsequent scholarship has identified the tale as post-medieval. As such, it is left out from most modern editions of the Mabinogion. Still, elements of the tale predate this presentation. This tale is distinct from the Book of Taliesin, which is a collection of poems attributed to Taliesin. According to the story, Taliesin began life as Gwyanbach, a servant to the enchantress Ceridwen. Ceridwen had a beautiful daughter and a horribly ugly son named Avigdu. Ceridwen determines to help her son by brewing a magic potion, the first three drops of which will give him the gift of wisdom and inspiration. The potion has to be cooked for a year and a day, so Ceridwen enlists a blind man named Morder to tend the fire beneath the cauldron, while Gwyanbach stirs. Three hot drops spill onto Gwyan's thumb as he stirred, and he instinctively puts his thumb in his mouth, instantly gaining wisdom and knowledge. The first thought that occurs to him is that Ceridwen will kill him, so he runs away. Soon enough, Ceridwen engages Gwyan in a transformation chase in which they turn themselves into various animals, a hare and a greyhound, a fish and an otter, and a bird and a hawk. Exhausted, Gwyan finally turns himself into a single grain of corn, but Ceridwen becomes a hen and eats him. Ceridwen becomes pregnant, and when she gives birth she throws the child into the ocean in a leather bag. The bag is found by Elfin, son of Gwydno Garanir, who sees the boy's beautiful white brow and exclaims, "Dyma Dalizen, Taliesin," thus named, begins to recite beautiful poetry. Elfin raises Taliesin as his son, and the two become involved in several adventures. In the presence of Maelgon, king of Gwynedd, Elfin claims that his wife is as virtuous as the king's wife, and that Taliesin is a better bard than the king's. Maelgon locks Elfin up and sends his boorish son Rhian to defile Elfin's wife and steal her ring as evidence. However, Taliesin has Elfin's wife replaced with a kitchen maid, thus preserving Elfin's claim. Taliesin then humiliates Maelgwn's bards with his skill, and frees his foster father. Arthurian tales Culch and Olwen. While Culch and Olwen, also found in the Mabinogion collection, is primarily an Arthurian tale, in which the hero Culch enlists Arthur's aid in winning the hand of Olwen, daughter of Yggdrasil the giant, it is full of background detail, much of it mythological in nature. Characters such as Amithon, the divine plowman, Mabinap Modron, the divine son, and the psychopomp Gwynap Nudd make appearances, the latter in an endless seasonal battle with Gwynap Greed, all for the hand of Creadilad. The conditions placed on Culch by his mother are similar to those placed on Lleulaw Gyfis by Arianrod, and Culch's arrival at Arthur's court is reminiscent of the Irish god Lugh's arrival at the court of King Nuada in Cathmai Gytured, Orwain, or the Lady of the Fountain. The hero of Orwain, or the Lady of the Fountain, is based on the historical figure Orwain Mabinogion. He appears as Ewain in later continental tradition. The romance consists of a hero marrying his love, the Lady of the Fountain, but losing her when he neglects her for knightly exploits. With the aid of a lion he saves from a serpent, he finds a balance between his marital and social duties and rejoins his wife. The narrative is related to Chrétien de Troyes' French romance Ewain, the Knight of the Lion. Peredur, son of Efrog. Like the other Welsh romances, scholars debate as to the work's exact relationship to Chrétien's poem. It is possible Peredur preserves some of the material found in Chrétien's source. The sequence of some events are altered in Peredur, and many original episodes appear, including the hero's 14-year sojourn in Constantinople reigning with the Empress, which contains remnants of a sovereignty tale. The Holy Grail is replaced with a severed head on a platter. Despite the differences, however, influence from the French romance cannot be discounted, particularly as its first part hardly matches the second. As in Percival, the hero's father dies when he is young, and his mother takes him into the woods and raises him in isolation. Eventually he meets a group of knights and determines to become like them, so he travels to King Arthur's court. There he is ridiculed by Kay and sets out on further adventures, promising to avenge Cei's insults to himself and those who defended him. While traveling he meets two of his uncles. The first plays the role of Percival's gournemant and educates him in arms and warns him not to ask the significance of what he sees. The second replaces Chrétien's Fisher King, but instead of showing Peredur the Holy Grail he reveals a salver containing a man's severed head. The young knight does not ask about this and proceeds to further adventure, including a stay with the Nine Witches of Gloucester and the encounter with the woman who was to be his true love, Angarad Goldenhand. Peredur returns to Arthur's court, but soon embarks on another series of adventures that do not correspond to material in Percival. Eventually the hero learns the severed head at his uncle's court belonged to his cousin, who had been killed by the Nine Witches of Gloucester. Peredur avenges his family, and is celebrated as a hero. The narrative corresponds to Chrétien's romance Perceval, the story of the Grail. Geraint, son of Eben. The romance concerns the love of Geraint, one of King Arthur's men, and the beautiful Enid. The couple marry and settle down together, but rumors spread that Geraint has gone soft. Upset about this, Enid cries to herself that she is not a true wife for keeping her husband from his chivalric duties. But Geraint misunderstands her comment to mean she has been unfaithful to him. He makes her join him on a long and dangerous trip and commands her not to speak to him. Enid disregards this command several times to warn her husband of danger. Several adventures follow that prove Enid's love and Geraint's fighting ability. The couple is happily reconciled in the end, and Geraint inherits his father's kingdom. The narrative corresponds to Chrétien's Erecan and Eid, in which the hero is Erec. Preiduannwfn. The Spoils of Annwfn is a cryptic early medieval poem of 60 lines found in the Book of Taliesin. The text recounts an expedition to the other world, led by King Arthur, to retrieve a magical cauldron. The speaker relates how he journeyed with Arthur and three boatloads of men into ANNWFN, but only seven returned. ANNWFN is apparently referred to by several names, including Mound Fortress, Four-Peaked Fortress, and Glass Fortress, though it is possible the poet intended these to be distinct places. Within the Mound Fort's walls, Gwyr, one of the three exalted prisoners of Britain, known from the Welsh triads, is imprisoned in chains. The narrator then describes the cauldron of the chief of ANNWN. It is finished with pearl and will not boil a coward's food. Whatever tragedy ultimately killed all but seven of them is not clearly explained. The poem continues with an excoriation of little men and monks, who lack in various forms of knowledge possessed by the poet.